wanted to do something a bit different for my 1 year progression video. Most people just do a sampler of all the best tricks they got. For me, unfortunately, I lost all my best tricks. I'm going to talk about my progression instead, and more specifically, how it all went to crap. For you people starting out, maybe I can give you some tips. Late November last year, that's when I got my backflips down. Not really down, I think I only sort of really understood backflips about 6 months ago. Still a lot of work I can do. I have sort of tried double back.
Oh shit!
And I have done. I reckon if I committed 100% to one, I can get it. Not bold enough to do double back yet. That's my mentality in flipping and stuff isn't very good. So if you follow the progression, I did backflip and then I did aerial. Aerial was pretty good. Just put a recent video of aerial. Everyone's like, it looked like a big kick, but it is a trickiest aerial. I know all the gymnasts bag out my cartwheels, but whatever, I'm not a gymnast. I don't have the flexibility to keep both my legs straight all the time. Then I did my gainers.
Yeah.
My swinging game is really horrible. I'll talk about that in a sec. All right, I gotta go on my phone and just check what my progression was like. I sort of forgot. Backflip, round offs. Then it was butterfly kicks and butterfly twist. I can't remember if I said this, but I had an A twist before I started tricking.
Oh, yeah, good.
Not a very good A twist, but that was like a foundation for my B twist. I'll talk more about B twist in a second. Yeah, then I learned corkscrew because a lot of people was like, it's a gainer than a B twist, which it really isn't. Don't think of it like that. It will confuse you. Oh, corkscrew is such a sad tale for me. I did learn it again quickly. I'll do it on grass. I attempted one on concrete. I was learning other things and I just sort of forgot about corkscrew. Came that day where I went a bit far and snapped my knee. That was a very big turning point in my tricking progression. It was weird because first day back I got corkscrew. After that day, I just couldn't do it anymore. That fear of snapping my knee again has just taken over and I did sort of get it back. It's super inconsistent these days. I don't like talking about it. Next is a calf full progression. So with calf full, you saw in the video, it was more of a cut B twist sort of thing. I'll talk about calf full in just a second. And then after calf full, I did touchdown rise. It was a journey and a half. My god, that was annoying. Touchdown rise is by far my favorite setup move. It's why I invested so much time into it. But that being said, it is a very difficult move. I did get touchdown rise gainer after a long time. Easy 7 months of trying to get touchdown. That was an issue because I was focusing so much time on touchdown rises that I wasn't doing any other move. It's how I lost Cox because I was just doing touchdown rise and trying to gain a ring out of it. Yeah. In hindsight, I should have spent less time on touchdown. I still can't get rise. Like, the rise is looking better. But it just feels so uncoordinated. I can't really swing out of it. So what I learned next was one of my biggest downfalls, which was hypers. Hyper full and hyper B twist.
Oh, my chest.
Those really screwed me up in a very weird sense. So when I got hyper B twist, that's all I trained, hyper B twist. I didn't even care about B twist swing throughs, which I was starting to get. So what happened is for both cart full and B twist, after just practicing hypers for ages, I couldn't stop hypering. B twist, I got back. A long time just trying to not hyper. I mean, apparently this is a very common thing to happen to all trickers when they learn hypers, and so you have to go back to basics. And that's what I did with my B twist. All I did was B kicks for so long. Try to get that really solid and then just turn a little bit. So I was landing on my back again. My calf full is absolutely trash. before I started hypering, I actually started to get some really good inversion into my fulls. I wanted just to do a normal cartful. I would just naturally spin that 90 degrees more and land on my right foot. For cartfuls, I will say, learn your cart Arabians first. I am trying to learn those now, and it is the biggest headache of my life because I'm so used to doing the full twist that when I do the cart Arabian, I'm already twisting, and when I land, it's pretty much a cartful. Even though I've lost a lot of tricks, my other stuff has been pretty on point now. So like, round off back I do with a ton of height. Nice. Kicks, my kicks are okay, getting there. Sort of done a cheat 9. What else am I working on right now? Gain of switches. I actually have got 0-0 once. Everyone told me to count it. Personally, I'm not. That's why I haven't made the video on it yet. Right now, focus is really cleaning up my B-twist. I want to swing it. Because one of my favorite moves is B-twist swing cork. That is really nice. B-twist swings. I want car full back. I want wrap full back as well, because they're cool. And Websters. And I am trying my best to get corks back. I am landing them very inconsistently, so maybe I'll do 10 a day, maybe land 2 of them. Even then, it'll be very either non-inverted or very low and shitty landings. So touchdown, rise, swing, gainer, I'll go back. I lost that as well. And I was pretty close to dub Bs and also cart dubs. Essentially, that's how I messed up my whole progression. Honestly, what happened was, if it comes down to it, I wasn't training enough. I was maybe doing 1 a week for a while because I was just working so much and I had to pay for my other hobbies, which are so expensive. And also, I was moving too fast for my own pace. Rushed everything. I am where I am with my tricking because of me. In my videos now, I don't say how many days it's been. I don't want to rush it anymore. I just want everything to be right. I always see you guys going like, how'd you learn this in 2 days? It doesn't matter if you learn it in 2 days, 2 weeks, 2 months. Get it down right the first time, because relearning things is tedious. It is a bit demotivating because a lot of people that has started around my time, there's a few people on Instagram that I follow that used to ask me for advice. They're killing the game at the moment, and I'm just like here trying to learn a B-twist again. And they've got cork swing through cork. It always has to be a bit of healthy competition. I don't really regret the way I've learned things. There's a lot of things I would do differently. Take things slow. Another thing is, don't get injured, because injury fucking sucks. That time off, I lost a ton of confidence and train a lot more than I did. God, I was lazy at one point because I thought I was so good and I was progressing really quickly. I would love to trick every day, but my body just can't take it. Like yesterday, I did a session in the gym. My hips right now are on fire still. And also my arms are killing me because I land on them so much. I'm just relearning a lot of things. Trying to get them really clean before I move on now. Thank you everyone for 4,000 subscribers. Means so much to me. I know I've been very lazy on the videos because I honestly haven't done anything new in so long. I hope you enjoyed this little bit of a different 1 year progression video. When I first started, I was gonna just do like this mad sampler of my 1 year. I thought I'd have dubs by now. I thought like I'll get swing through, cork swing throughs. I'm not gonna give up on it. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe. Hopefully things go out better this year. Also, you're probably wondering why I'm doing a 1 year progression video in March when I started in November. Apparently you don't count injury months. So I was injured for 1 month with my ankle, and then I was injured 3 months for my knee. So 4 months all up. There was some here and there injuries with the neck and stuff, but I'm not gonna count like a week off or something.